It's only a paper moon. Ah, the phone.
Hello?
Hello, sir. Is your refrigerator running?
Yes.
Well, you better go catch it.
What? Get out of here!
The nerve of some people! It's only a paper moon. Ah, the phone again.
Hello?
Hello, is Mr. Wall there, please?
There's no Mr. Wall here. Sorry.
Can I speak with Mrs. Wall, then?
Mrs. Wall does not live here.
Well, can I speak with Harry Wall, please?
There's no one here by that name either. Sorry.
Are there any walls there?
No, there are no walls here. Sorry.
Then may I ask what's holding up your house?
What? Another crank call? Damn, get out of here.
Oh, look. I've got a phone message there.
This call is officially a final notice from IRS, Internal Revenue Services. The reason for this call is to inform you that IRS is filing a lawsuit against you. To get more information about this case file, please call immediately on our department number 202-239-1094. Hi.
Oh no, the IRS! They must have found out about that money I got from posing naked! I didn't declare it! I better call them back and set this straight.
Thanks for calling the Internal Revenue Services. Your call is very important for us, so leave your name, number, and this message.
Yes, this is Dickels Flockett speaking. I received a message about the IRS and my impending arrest. What's going on here? Please, can we settle this? I'm too old to go to jail. Please, help me. Well, here's another fine mess I've gotten myself into.
Well, hello, everybody. Welcome to part five. Can't believe it's part five already. To this 1932 Mystery Cathedral Radio.
Hello.
Now, today I'm going to experiment with some wood here. This is sort of a experimenting with buzz segment.
Oh no, not again.
And I just wanted to see if I can get this veneer to bend into this shape here. Now I was reading up on veneer softener, and it's kind of expensive, so what I'm going to do here is try to do the cheap man's version of it. Now I'm going to use denatured alcohol, and you're also supposed to use glycerin. But I don't have glycerin. It's 6 o'clock in the morning and the stores are closed and I'm not going to go out and get it. I'm going to try this first. This is all about experimentation and I enjoy doing it.
Me too.
So I have a piece of wood here about 33 inches. This is approximately the size of the wood I'm going to need to bend. And what I'm going to do here is I've got the center measured here. I'm going to just put some denatured alcohol down here and then see if I can start to bend this. You see, if I go any farther from this bend here, it's going to crack, even though I'm bending it with the grain. So let me try that and see what happens. This stuff is fun. And, you know, I'm not here to teach anybody, so if you think you're going to be learning anything, well, you'll probably be learning from my mistakes, but I am not a cabinet maker. I don't want to be a cabinet maker. I'm just experimenting. The cheap man's way. Or the poor man's way.
You're just cheap.
And I see that evaporates pretty fast, so let me get this out of the way. I'm just gonna start to see if I can start to bend it here. Yeah. I think that's working. Let me just, I need three hands to do this. I'm just going to apply some more here.
Don't give up your day job.
I don't want to let that slip or it's going to slap me in the face. Of course, I could use a couple of slaps in the face sometimes.
When you're slapped, you'll take it and like it.
Okay, Now I'm going to take a heat gun.
This guy runs a little hot, but he gets the job done.
This will evaporate the denatured alcohol.
Please make me a drink of grain alcohol and rainwater and help yourself to whatever you'd like.
I have never attempted to make a cathedral top.
Me neither.
And this is going to be my first one and probably my last one.
You've got to think positively, you get it?
I don't plan to make a hobby out of doing this. I'd rather stick just to the radio repairs, but sometimes you got to do this stuff.
Aw, that's sissy talk. Regular guys don't talk like that.
So this is telling me that this might work pretty well. I don't have to spend $15 on veneer softener. So I can do it the cheap way.
Well, of all the cheap, lousy ways to save a buck.
Now, I'm not going to let go of this.
Don't try to be a hero. You don't have to be a hero. Not for me.
But I need to get it in this shape. As you can see, it's not that critical of a bend as much as I've got it here, but I'm doing overkill here because it's going to spring back.
What is he babbling about?
Okay. So, if I were to have the bigger piece, what I would do is I'd probably put some glue here. Tack a nail on here and keep going all the way down until I've got that on there. But look at that.
Look here, amigo. You got the wrong idea.
That's gonna work.
Confidence is very sexy, don't you think?
How about that? My first time. I just spilled my alcohol over there. I better get rid of this before Dickel drinks it.
I'll drink to that.
So there you go. Bending the 16th inch veneer into the shape of a cathedral radio.
I congratulate you, little boy. Well done.
It ain't that hard. What do you know about that?
Hell yeah.
Okay, here is the cabinet front. The nice thick piece of veneer that I put on. It's relatively flat. A little bit of wobble there, but not going to worry about it. Today I'm going to, I need to cut out all this excess material. And I've already done this. It's not an easy job because the veneer is a 16th of an inch. But what I'm going to do is just drill a hole here.
You've got to be kidding me.
And do it the old-fashioned way with an X-Acto knife.
Oh, brother!
Just make cuts like that.
Does anybody want a cough drop?
So, it's going to take me many hours to get this done with all that. But I'm not going to bore you with me doing this. I'll show you what it looks like when I got it finished. Well, I thought I'd show you my progress here. I got one more thing to do here. So I thought I'd just show you as I'm doing this one, and we can play a nice old tune to keep you entertained. So let's get that done.
Mm-hmm.
I text what you say.
Step aside, partner, it's my day. Bend an ear and listen to my version
of a really solid Tennessee excursion.
Pardon me, boy, is that the Chattanooga choo-choo?
Yes, yes, track 29.
Boy, you can give me a shine.
Can you afford to board Chattanooga choo-choo?
I got my fare
and just a trifle to spare.
You leave the Pennsylvania station about a quarter to four. Read a magazine and then you're in Baltimore.
Dinner in the diner, nothing could be finer
than to have your ham and eggs in Carolina.
When you hear the whistle blowing 8 to the bar, then you know that Tennessee is not very far.
Shovel all the coal in, gotta keep it rolling.
Woo-woo, Chattanooga, there you are.
There's gonna be a certain party at the station.
Satin and lace.
I used to call Funny Face. She's gonna cry until I tell her that I'll never roll.
So Chattanooga choo-choo,
won't you choo-choo me home?
Chattanooga, Chattanooga,
all aboard.
Chattanooga, Chattanooga,
get aboard.
Chattanooga, Chattanooga, Chattanooga choo-choo,
won't you choo-choo me home?
Chattanooga choo-choo.
All right, now all I have to do is sand it. Oh, wifey, I have a job for you.
Clean up your own mess, you jerk.
I have received a package here from Gary from Playthings of the Past. You know, that's the company that I got the Transformer from. Let's just open this and see what I ordered from him, okay? What kind of goodies did old Buzz order? Any guesses out there?
Now, suppose you tell us all about it.
First of all, I ordered a tube manual. I always wanted one. I'm tired of going on the internet and looking up stuff that way. This is a lot easier. I also ordered a 10K switch. Looks like it's a Philco part.
Well, how can you trifle with such inconsequentialities?
We'll have to test that and see if it works. And let's look in this package here, shall we? There's the tube in there. I don't know if I ordered the tube, but look what I've got. It's an escutcheon.
Wow! Wow! All I can say is wow!
Just like the one in the picture.
This is so nice.
Boy, it's been a long time since you had an escutcheon on you. Let's see what it looks like. Beautiful. Even the holes line up right. That's the one that was in there. Pretty cool, huh? So now the unknown cathedral has a escutcheon. Beautiful. Let's see what's in here, because I didn't order no tube.
Please hurry up.
Looky here. Why, we have a couple of knobs. Look at that.
Very nice, Pat.
Don't that look like the picture?
It's perfect! I won't have to change this at all!
Well, you're gonna look smart, baby.
Oh, yes!
And what do we got here, I wonder? Why, it's those decorative screws that hold the speaker in. So here we go. Got the decorative screw. We got the knobs. And the escutcheon.
Beautiful, Chumley. Beautiful.
Thank you, Gary. Thank you very much.
Well, you're welcome.
Got me some half-inch plywood.
Well, back to the old drawing board.
Yeah, I'm going to cut this one out. I'm going to use this long one here, so when I cut it out here, I'll have a piece that I could use as a sort of a brace while I'm gluing it on there. I'll show you that later if you don't quite get what I mean. Well, it's about an hour later, and here's the original one, and here's the two I did. Nothing spectacular, they're not perfect, but they should do the job. I've got the extra one there. This is the sheet of veneer I'm going to work with. And I've got the length measured out. Now I got to figure out how wide this thing is. Measure is 7, 1, 2, 3, 7 and 3/8. So I'm going to mark in 7 and 3/8 here and then have to trim this up. Okay, I did a little cutting, but I still need to trim here and all the way up 34 inches. And I can't chance it with the saw because the stuff doesn't saw quite right. So I dug some tin snips up I had since I was in my 20s. And I'm just going to use these tin snips and do it.
Oh, brother.
You got to be careful because it wants to go with the grain and mess up there. So I'm just going to be very careful. I got it cut down to the right shape. I ended up having to take the knife and a ruler and score this a little bit. And then use these and it worked a lot faster. But I did screw up here. See how it kind of split out here.
Aww.
I'm going to have to glue that. It's going to be at a critical point where it's being bent, so hopefully the glue will hold that. If not, then I'll have to do it again. And this is a lot of work. So I'm not looking forward to that if I have to do it again. But I can't do anything until this thing is glued and dry. So, all right, I have my veneer laid out here. This is the center line. This portion is the rear section. This will go flush against the bottom edge here. The other brace, which is the front, is going to be recessed, and it's going to go about right here.
Mm-hmm.
This area here is for glue blocks, according to the picture I've got. So, it's time to bend this. Now I'm going to bend it off camera because I've already shown you how to bend it. And once I get it to the point of gluing, we're going to glue. Hallelujah! I'm going to put some contact cement here and a little bit here. And then I'm going to cut this mark as the center. And I'm going to nail it. One nail, two, three, four, five, whatever I need. Here goes nothing. And I mean nothing.
Boy, you are nuts. NVTS nuts.
I have no idea how this is going to turn out. My only other backup plan is if it doesn't work, I'll start over again. I'll see you in a few minutes. Well, here goes nothing. did the other side off camera because there was a lot of cussing going on. Anyway, this is what I was mentioning about this piece as a brace. It's gonna leave this clamped in here like this for an hour or so while that glue sets. Okay, it's time for the final brace. As you can see, I went to the Ace Hardware. I got a bunch of these clamps here. And I got smart this time. I've got these holes pre-drilled here, and I'm going to use screws.
No, 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 dumb scum.
I just got to line this up.
Even in most primitive man, the need to create was part of his nature.
Right, I'm going to do that off camera and I'll show you the result. Don't go away.
Hey, come on! Cut the clowning, will you?
You're looking at the most obstinate project I have ever worked on. If I was going to do this again, I would put these boards in first, make sure these are true, and then once we got that, then we can put these other braces in here. Because I think I got one brace curved a little bit where it shouldn't be. I hope once I get this piece in here that I can fix that.
Mickey Mouse, Mickey Mouse.
I give myself a D minus on this. I was ready to throw it in the trash and start over again. But I don't want to go through this again. So there you have it. Cathedral top.
See you real soon.
And the old original one.
Like you.
Thanks for watching. See you next time. This is Buzz.